Working together with your significant other can be amazing, but it can also be a little bit challenging. So in this video, I want to cover some of my experience after we've been working with my wife together in the business for a year now. Everybody, what's up and welcome to another segment of Business Time where I share some of my experience after running my own business. So I've been basically freelancing for over 6 years now full-time, and for the last year my wife actually joined the business. It started off a pretty lightweight and grew, her role in the business grew. So let me basically share the story. So I was freelancing, as I said, working as a designer for over 6 years, and also started last year selling an online course. And my wife, basically my wife and me actually met when I was working in advertising agency, and she was working in the advertising agency as an account manager, and she worked a lot in marketing. And afterward, she actually made a transition, and she was taking some time off after we had our second kid, and she was looking into, she actually took an interior design course and was looking to work as an interior designer. But while she was looking for a job, she was kind of like at home and wasn't earning money. And she was like, maybe I can help you in the business. Now, for me, initially, that was great because for two reasons. First one, I hate doing the accounting for myself. And so I was like, if you can handle the accounting, generating all the invoices, managing all the spreadsheet and working with the accountant and everything, that can save up so much of my mental energy. That can also be amazing. The second reason that that was good was because I could actually, instead of taking, because I was, let's say, the sole provider of the home, I could decrease my salary so that I would pay less tax and I could pay her a salary. And she, because we're based in Israel, and so the law is in Israel that if you're a mother and if you're a mother working, you're paying less taxes. So the tax situation for us as a family was actually better by working together and kind of like splitting the income instead of me taking everything and paying a lot of tax. By both of us having smaller salaries, we actually saved up money on tech. So those were basically the reason for us to get started. Now, as the business grew during the last year and I've started focusing more on selling online courses, which actually changed the business, and there were a lot of new things then and new methodologies that we started using. I've shared some of them, like how we track our profit loss versus cash flow. Recently, we also had to, we started a new company both in Israel, and we started a US company, which makes it easier for us in terms of accounting and all sorts of stuff. So there was a lot of bureaucracy and also kind of like spreadsheet work that had to be done in terms of accounting, and her role kind of like grew and grew. So that's basically the story of how we work together. Now let's talk about kind of like the pros and cons, and let's start with the bottom line. The bottom line is, for us right now, this is basically a perfect combination because we're both working, you know, on the same mission. She's very, very flexible, which was something that was very important for her. So she can spend the mornings doing, you know, the work for us and then spending the afternoon with the kids. She doesn't have a boss. I mean, a boss that she doesn't know, or she has to do what he says, right? Because we're basically partners. So she has much more flexibility. And even though that, you know, as I said, initially she started working with me while she was looking for a full-time job as an interior designer. After a while, she actually said, you know what? I really enjoy, you know, doing this. I really enjoy the flexibility and I like working with you. So I actually want to keep doing that instead of, I will not go look for another full-time position because right now my situation is great and I'm enjoying this. And for me, obviously, it was great because I could, you know, that managing the finance is something that, you know, taking care of the money, the bank account, is something that requires the highest level of trust. So for me to find somebody else, and as I said, I hate doing this, the fact that I hate doing this and don't want to spend time doing it means I'm doing it badly usually. So for me to find somebody that I trust in that level to take care of my bank account and my finances and taxes and everything, it's very hard to find something that you trust on this level. Now, for her, that's the easy because she's the person that I trust most in the world. So having her deal with that is a perfect solution from my end. So basically, it's a really, really good fit for both of us. And I actually, you know, after we started doing this and I've started to talk with some other of my friends who either are freelancers or run their own agencies, I found out that a lot of kind of like, let's say, creative couples work in that manner. And it works great for a lot of people. Now, there are obviously things that you need to, that might create friction, and that friction, because you're a couple and you're running a family, might bleed into family life. So you really have to be careful about that. Some of the things that bothered me, you know, so the way that we work, basically she works from home. So she's basically worked remotely and we have one meeting per week, which is basically an office meeting. So we either do it in this office or at our home office, but basically we have one meeting per week. And then obviously we talk on the phone or email or if we need something specific, but because we only have one meeting per week, sometimes I would come back home and we, you know, we would go to bed at late at night. And we, by the time that we got into bed, she was like, oh, by the way, you know what happened today? And we got to do this and this, that. And for me, I like to try and switch off when I go back home, try to switch off from work mode. And it was pretty frustrating for me to start thinking about work whenever she brought up issues, and sometimes again in bed late at night or on the weekend, it didn't feel like right for me. But then again, for her, it was also frustrating not to have me listen to her, because as she's, you know, dealing with this the whole day long, we're not always communicated on a daily basis because we have only one meeting per week. So she needed somebody to talk about this, and she lacked that. So we had to find the boundaries about when do we talk about these things, when it's okay, where do we cross, where do we put the line. We do, you know, every quarter we try to have the conversation to see if this still works for us, if she's still happy about this, if she doesn't feel like, I was really worried that she might feel like she's like supporting me and not doing what's right for her. Maybe she wants to pursue her own career. So I'm trying to be very much aware of that. And every 3 months or something, like, have this conversation. Are you happy? Are you sure that's what you want to do? That's what you want to do long term? And as I said, for us, we've managed to find that kind of like boundaries, the right boundaries, that she gets what she needs and I get what I need, to make sure that it works well. And it actually is a great, great fun for us to do this thing together and feel like we're on a mission together when we're doing something together. And she's also, it's not like I come back work and I come back home and tell her about my day at the office. She's really engaged. She knows what's going on in my business. She knows, you know, if I'm deciding to take some risks or do this or that, she knows she has the context about why this happens and if we're safe economically or something. So by her being involved in that, really aligns us as a family. And I find it really, really helpful and enjoyable to run a business that way. Hopefully that was helpful if you're considering to work with your significant other. Let me know what your thoughts are or your struggles or your principles or tips for working with your significant other in the comments. I'll see you on the next video.